So wait, Robert, who is Robert? Who is this person? I'm like, what's her name? She's training with Ricky. What is she known for?
She's been in novelas and everything. She does a lot of teatro de obra. Yeah, like
theater.
Yeah, a lot of theater. Not comedy, but theater. Not. She does some novelas too. Cause she was married to a big novela producer.
Orozco.
Juan Osorio.
Osorio. Yeah. She's Cuban,
yeah.
But the Mexicans love her.
Juan Osorio discovered her, and he's a big time novelas producer. So now they got a divorce, and then she went and married somebody else. Yeah, Nurka Marcos, she's pretty famous, man. The Mexican, the Latino community. I don't know where she was training. Fuck yeah.
I didn't know who it was. I just.
Yeah, she's very famous.
No?
Very famous. It's
beautiful. But you guys
That's good. Fucking Ricky, man. Damn, Ricky. Send some over to Riverside.
Yeah, dude, I just got
I was at his gym this morning. I'm trying to think. Oh, Joseph Diaz was sparring one. 8 rounds.
Oh, yeah.
It was very good sparring.
Is that right? Oh,
that's Joseph Diaz, very talented. Very talented.
Yeah. All right.
It's right. A lot of good fighters here in Southern California, man. Right. You know, the next 5 years, Southern California's gonna take over. Why? Southern California.
You know?
Okay, let me ask you and Manny. Now that Mayweather retired, who's the best pound for pound king as of this morning?
As of right now?
Right now.
Let me see. Chocolate. I think there's gonna be one of them. You know, they're gonna put probably Triple G on one of those. And then, what's the name from
Oakland? They're all there. But
Andrew Ward. You know, it depends on which kind of fighter you want. If you tell me, I say Chocolatito. But then some people are going to pick Triple G. Some people are going to pick Andrew Ward.
But here's the thing. Mayweather fought Canelo, De La Hoya, Marquez. I'm saying he fought the big, big names. Mm-hmm. Chocolatito hasn't fought the biggest names.
But I'm talking about
Triple G hasn't fought.
I would pick Kovalev because he holds the IBF.
He's like undisputed almost. He's in the WBC.
And the WBA. But, he knows.
Yeah.
You know,
how about Rigondeaux?
Rigondeaux is a scary motherfucker. He's scary, man.
What are you saying?
Rigondeaux has a fine.
Yeah, Rigondeaux, you know, like I said, some people might pick Rigondeaux because, you know, depending on what kind of style you
nobody
like and what kind of
trainer
you are.
Yeah.
Me, I like Chocolate. That's a fight.
Nobody wants to fight it.
Ring Magazine picked him as the best pound for pound.
I like him as a fighter, yeah. You know, it's like there's a lot of fighters that people never even mentioned, but I've mentioned him before. You know, kid, what's his name from Texas? What part of the numbers? He retired a long time ago.
Orlando Canizales.
Jesse Reed talks about him all the time.
He's from Laredo, Texas.
Man, that guy had skills, bro.
But what happened to him?
Well, he's retired. Man. He's retired, but yeah.
Defeated?
No, he was undefeated.
Now he lost.
He had defeated to be a good fighter. Bro.
But
he was a
bad fighter. Over 15 title defenses.
Yeah, he was good.
You
know,
you don't see that.
Finito Lopez was all his skills. You could see those skills there. You know, which was a really good boxer too that I really used to like. Humberto Roman.
What made him good?
Skills, bro.
Skills.
Hit and don't get hit.
Yeah, exactly.
Actually,
one punch knockout. Too, you know, they had some powers. Those guys, they were good, man.
What are you saying, Manny?
You got the Pernell Whitakers, the Rigondeaux, the Mayweathers, who are very defensive, who could also be pound for pound, depending on which trainer likes that style. You know what I mean? The way I like to pick a fighter, I like Chocolatito.
He has a tough fight coming up. Brian Valoria. Brian could hit. I think Brian's going
to
knock him out.
I don't think so, but I would like to see it.
I think so.
Brian does that. You know, he surprises me.
Are you recording this?
Yeah.
Stay away.
Why? What's wrong with that?
I don't know.
Hey, Brian hits hard, bro. You know, remember when nobody thought he was going to beat Archie Zolino?
Is it one of your first champions? You're one of your first champions? Your second champion? He's a cool dude. Man, he's a cool dude. I'm telling you. He could pull it off. He could crack too.
But Chocolatito could fight, man. Right now, I don't know. Maybe
I know. Brian's a great individual.
Great kid.
Great individual. I mean, it's just, you're talking about
Chocolatito
being probably one of the best fighters in the world. And then.
Everyone's beatable.
Everybody's
except Mayweather.
Everybody's beatable.
Mayweather never lost. How would you fight him, man? Against Brito, we look great. Brito couldn't touch him.
He just does what he has to do, man. That's
smart fighter.
What's crazy is if De La Hoya boxed for the last two rounds against Trinidad, everybody booed him, and he's a fucking chicken. He's that. And Mayweather boxes the last round, and everybody cheering him, man. Yeah, you know what I mean? It's crazy, huh? The way the world, the fans are.
One fighter could do one thing and they accept it, another fighter does it, and they hate on him.
It's the way it is, man. But he boxes good, man. He does enough to win.
Can you pause real quick?
Yeah.